What's happened to the goals in your team? Why have they dried up a little bit?
It's difficult to understand also, but I think one is the reason why we are not playing so well. Maybe the other time when Sergio was injured, we could cover him without problem. In this last month, we are not scoring too much goals, and we are conscious about that. It's not easy to say one reason what happened, but of course we are worried about that.
In English, we call this a blip, where something doesn't quite go so well, but that it, you know, you hope to get over it. Are you confident you can get over this blip?
I hope, as I said, that we will continue playing the way we played at the beginning. No, not the beginning, until 1 month ago. I also it's important to remember how difficult to score goals. When we score every day, every week 4 or 5 or 6 goals, everyone was talking about the way, if we defend well or we don't defend well. I think it's more important to score, and that's why I always try to have attacking teams. In this moment, for different reasons, as I said, we are not scoring as much as we need, and I hope that we will return a normal performance of different players and a high performance as a team.
How is Jovetic?
Jovetic is also, I think, it's a very important player that we cannot use him the whole year. I hope that now or next week, if he comes back, he can do all what we expect about him, because we have 12 games more of Premier League. It's mostly third part of the Premier League, so I hope he will contribute a lot in this last part of the season.
Manuel, with Sergio, he's had a lot of injuries this season, calf injuries, hamstrings. Are you concerned that with the World Cup in the summer, he's not going to get the rest he needs to recover properly and just let his body recover?
I am concerned about not to have the possibility to use Sergio more much this season. I think Sergio is a very important player for us. Unfortunately for him, he has two or three injuries. I hope he recover and finish playing the way he knows, because it's very important for Manchester City. And also, it's very important for him, for his national team. I think for every national team, I don't think that the players are thinking about the World Cup. I think that if they want to do a good World Cup, they have good performance in the last part of the season.
From Man City's perspective, if he had a free summer, he could rest up the injuries, because after the Watford game, he was injured against Tottenham. He played against Wigan, he was injured against Madrid. It's almost against Barcelona. It's almost as though his body has been overworked and he needs the rest.
But you can think a lot of things, but Sergio must play with his national team in the World Cup, so we'll try to recover him as soon as he can. We'll see how many matches he can play, and after the World Cup, he must have a rest to try to have a good season this year.
Manuel, this nine-point gap to Chelsea, I know you have 3 games in hand, does it worry you just because the games are starting to run out? You know, you have to win these games, obviously. Is
it
a concern?
Concern not. Of course, it's better if we play. If we already played those 3 games and we win it, of course it's better. Now you must win it. But in a moment, Chelsea did it. So we must do it in the future. If we want to win the Premier League, you must do things better than the other teams. And maybe small things or little things can make a difference. But I repeat, I'm not talking only about Chelsea. I think that Liverpool has a lot of options, and Arsenal also.
Every time Mourinho says City is still favourites, privately, do you have a little bit of a laugh at his bare-faced cheek?
Probably what?
Every time Mourinho says City are still favourites, do you have a little laugh to yourself privately, because he's, in English we say, he's being cheeky?
No, I don't give importance to those things. Maybe some part of the newspapers thinks that other managers are very smart or play very mind games. For me, I really never read and never hear about other things.
Do you feel there's a bit extra pressure now, Manuel, to win the league now that you've gone out of the FA Cup and the Champions League? Because if you don't, you just have the League Cup to show for the season. Would that be an acceptable season if you finish with just the League Cup?
No, I don't think it's an extra pressure, because the pressure may be in the way I think. For me, the pressure is exactly the same from the first game of the Premier League till the end game. if we won Capital One, and I said after we won, that pressure, we finished one competition and we won, nothing more, and we can continue maybe now in FA Cup, and the pressure to win the title of the Premier League is exactly the same, winning the FA Cup or not winning the FA Cup, or continue Champions League or not continue in this moment, for me the pressure to win the Premier is exactly the same.
Manuel, yeah. How was the experience in Barcelona, not being in the dugout, watching the game from the stands?
A bad experience.
A bad experience? Why was it a bad experience?
Because you live the match a different way. For me it's better to be in the touchline and be near the players, and you live the game in a different way.
And with City's running, I mean, there's the United to go to Arsenal, Liverpool, Everton. Is that a challenge that you relish, or obviously it's more difficult than your rivals?
No, I don't think that we have not more difficult, not easy than against our rival. You never know which is the most difficult rival. Maybe in the first in the first part of the season, in the first round, the big teams were easy for us, that smaller team. So for me, all the teams are exactly the same. We must try to recover the way we are playing, and we'll see at the end of the season which team did the well.
How
did the best at the end?
After seeing your team play Barcelona twice, how close do you think you are to winning the Champions League in the future?
No, I think that one year, nothing, you can compare one year with another year. The moments are different, the teams are in different moments. I repeat that both games against Barcelona, both of them, especially the first one we played with one player less, till that moment I think that we were very close against what Barcelona did in Etihad, and also there in their own field. So that's a thing that we analyze at the end of the season and we'll think about next year.
And just in terms of the Premier League now, Arsenal are still involved in the FA Cup, Chelsea are still involved in the Champions League. Does that give you an advantage in the Premier League?
No. Arsenal had just one game more for FA Cup, and we have three games postponed, so we are going to play more against that Arsenal from now till the end of the season. So Arsenal is in the same way, as our team, Liverpool also, and Chelsea, they have one game more in Champions League. We'll see if they continue. If they continue, of course, it's more games, but they play less game in January and February. So I think that anything has any advantage.
So you're hoping Chelsea can beat Galatasaray and continue in the Champions League?
Pardon?
So are you hoping that Chelsea can continue in the Champions League?
I am not thinking about Chelsea, really. Nothing about Chelsea.
Good, guys.